to the Buck. I am your host, Josh Davidson. Today, we will be going through week 9 of the NFL, results from fantasy football, and my week 10 predictions. But before we get started today, we have a sponsor for this podcast, the Clark County Student Council, which is sponsored by Mrs. Flubb. The Student Council consists of 5 elected representatives from each grade level and 4 elected officers. The Student Council promotes student and faculty spirit and unity, serves as a liaison between the student body, administrators, and the school board. Meetings are held before school on the last Friday of each month. Members attend the Northeast District Convention during the fall semester and serve as volunteers when needed for various school and community events, such as they are responsible for reading the school bulletin each morning and cleaning the microwaves in the commons at the end of each week. The president for this group is Acadia Halford, the vice president is Garrett Billings, the secretary is Katie Eyre, and the treasurer is Jocelyn Weed. Now moving on to week 9 of the NFL, where I will provide the game score and what record both teams are after that game. First game we have is the Eagles and Texans. Final score was 29-17, Eagles win. This puts the Eagles at 8-0, they are first in the NFC East. The Texans are now 1-6-1. They are last in the AFC South. Eagles barely held on against a terrible 1-6 team, and I just think they're overrated. Next game we have is the Colts and Patriots. The final score was 26-3, Patriots win. This puts the Patriots at 5-4. They are last in the AFC East. The Colts are now 3-5, and they are second in the AFC South. Patriots defense had around 35 fantasy points this game, and they did pretty dang good. Next game we have is Lions and Packers. Final score was 15-9, Lions win. This puts the Lions at 2-6, and they are last in the NFC North. The Packers are now 3-6, and this puts them tied for second with the Bears. Packers, what happened? How did you lose to the Lions? And what I think is Aaron Rodgers desperately needs receivers. He just can't do it without Davante Adams, and Davante Adams can't do it without him. The next game we have is Chargers and Falcons. Final score was 20-17, Chargers win. This puts the Chargers at 5-3, and they are second in the AFC West. The Falcons are now 4-5, which makes them tied for first in the NFC South. Atlanta somehow choked a decent lead again. It follows them. Next game we have is the Bills and Jets. The final score was 20-17, Jets win. This puts the Jets at 6-3, and they are second in the AFC East. The Bills are now 6-2, and they are still first in their division. Jets doing pretty good, and Sauce Gardner is him. Next game we have Vikings and Commanders. Final score was 20-17, Vikings win. The Vikings are now 7-1, ranked first in their division. The Commanders, who are now last in their division, sitting at 4-5. Next game we have is Bengals and Panthers. Final score 42-21, Bengals win. The Bengals are now 5-4, ranked second in the AFC North. The Panthers sitting at a cool 2-7, ranked last in their division. Joe Mixon is him. He had 5 total touchdowns and 4 on the ground, 1 receiving touchdown. He is a fantasy nightmare with 55 points. I still lost with him somehow. I don't know how. PJ Walker, who was replaced in the second half, was way overhyped. It just took a good team to expose him. Bengals basically putting their JV on Carolina. It is just not Carolina's year or has ever been. Next game we have is Jaguars and Raiders, where I think Raiders are just pathetic. Final score was 27-20. Jaguars win. The Jags are ranked third in their division, sitting at 3-6. The Raiders, with a pathetic record of 2-6, ranked last in their division. Raiders just straight up stink. They lost a lead to the Jags. No one is playing good, and they're way overhyped. Davante Adams once again needs A-Rod, and Trevor Lawrence is him. Next game we have is Dolphins and Bears. Final score was 35-32. Dolphins win. Dolphins are now tied for second in their division and sitting in 6-3. Bears are now 3-6. Justin Fields with 42 fantasy points. MVP season, question mark? Fields played an excellent game. Is he underrated? Good game overall for everyone. The next game we have is Seahawks and Cardinals. The Seahawks won 31-21. I think the Seahawks are doing very great this year, and they are real playoff contenders and, shoot, maybe even Super Bowl contenders. Geno Smith is him. He never gave up. He's got that dog in him. Kenneth Walker is also a very talented running back. Kyler Murray, on the other hand, he needs to retire already. He is way too small. That missed snap really was funny and made him just look insanely short. Next game we have is Buccaneers at Rams. Buccaneers won 16-13. Tom Brady is showing GOAT status again. He had less than a minute to come back, and he proved his point. He won. He is him. Next game we have is Chiefs and Titans. The Chiefs won 20-17 in overtime after winning a coin toss. I noticed that no one wanted to tackle Derrick Henry at all, but who would? Next game we have is the Ravens and Saints. The Ravens won 27-13. This was a horrible game for the Saints and a horrible game for Kamara, who was on my fantasy team, but luckily I still won. A funny play from that game is Lamar Jackson fumbling from his own lineman. Now the bye week teams this week were the Pittsburgh Steelers, the Giants, the Cowboys, Browns, Broncos, and the 49ers. Now I will be moving on to fantasy football, and I will be doing the leaders and week 9 leaders. The leaders currently for QB is Josh Allen with 215 points. Running back is Derrick Henry with 155 points. I didn't really see this coming. The wide receiver is Tyreek Hill with 130.9 points. The tight end is Travis Kelce with 110 points. A defensive team is the Patriots with 102 points. They took over Dallas. And if your league has a defensive player, the best guy you could have right now is Roquan Smith with 93.5 points. Now for the week 9 leaders, the QB is Justin Fields, where he had 42.72 points. And out of nowhere, the week 9 running back leader was Joe Mixon with 55 points, with over 200 yards and 5 touchdowns. The best wide receiver you could have this week is Davante Adams with 26.6 points. Out of nowhere, and a real shocker, the best tight end you could have this week was Cole Kmet with 17 points. The best defense you could have this week was the Patriots with 24 points. And again, if your league has a defensive player, the best player you could have is Javon Hargrave with 20.4 points. Now I will be moving on with week 10 predictions. Kicking it off with Thursday Night Football with the Falcons and Panthers. Both very, very mid teams, and I think the Panthers will start Baker Mayfield instead of P.J. Walker, considering P.J. Walker just got exposed by the Bengals defense and got sit at the half. But I'm going to go with the Panthers here because Falcons are just choke masters, and I got faith in the Panthers. Next game we have is the Seahawks and Buccaneers. Probably going to be a pretty good shootout considering Tom Brady is in GOAT form again. And the Seahawks are a very good team this year. And I think the Seahawks offense will expose the Buccaneers defense and just score all over them. Kenneth Walker will have a good game, I'm guessing, and Geno Smith will too. Both teams are going to have very, very high scores, but I'm going to take the Seahawks here. Next game we have is the Lions and Bears. Most people smirk at this matchup, but both teams are kind of decent. Lions just came off with a win from Green Bay, and the Bears came off with a very, very tough loss at the Dolphins. But Justin Fields is looking really, really good this year, and the Bears are actually looking pretty decent. Both teams just not that great, but I'm going to go with the Bears here. Next game we have is the Browns and Dolphins. The Dolphins just came off with a win from the Bears, and the Browns just, Jacoby Brissett is not that good, and they just don't have that good of an offense, honestly. Their defense is okay, but the Dolphins, with Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle, they'll be throwing the ball a lot and just dominating the Browns' defense. I got the Dolphins winning. Next game we have is the Broncos and Titans. Broncos are just not cooking it anymore, just like Russ. And the Titans have Derrick Henry and Malik Willis on their offense. And I got the Titans winning here because they just put up a really, really good fight against the Chiefs, who apparently is the best team in the league. Next game we have is the Vikings and Bills. Josh Allen will be looking for redemption from last week after losing to the Jets. The Vikings just came off with a win, and Kirk Cousins is just off the perk 30 on that plane. But I got the Bills winning here for redemption. Next game we have is the Texans and Giants. Texans just straight up stink. They got a decent defense with Derek Stingley Jr., but with Saquon Barkley, the Giants are just unstoppable, and it's go time, baby. I got the Giants winning. Next game we have is Jaguars and Chiefs. I got the Jaguars winning here. I know that sounds crazy, but I'm predicting an upset, and I really, really hope the Jaguars win. Chiefs fans will never shut up about it. Next game we have is the Saints and Steelers. I got the Saints winning here just because the Steelers are just not good this year. They straight up stink. Kenny Pickett is a pretty good quarterback, but he just doesn't have that much knowledge when it comes to the NFL. He's just not ready yet. He's just a rookie. But with Claypool being traded and George Pickens being moved up to wide receiver 2, I think that he's going to get targeted more and he's going to have a pretty good season. But Saints are probably going to win here. Next game we have is the Colts and Raiders. This will probably be like the most pathetic game we've seen all year. The Colts just straight up stink and the Raiders just straight up stink. Probably going to have high scoring games just because they both straight up stink. But if I had to pick one, I'd go Raiders just because of Davante Adams, and I feel like he's going to have a good game, but it's still pathetic. Next game we have is Cardinals and Rams. The Rams are not that good. They straight up stink. Their offense is not good. And the Cardinals' defense and offense is pretty decent, even though they just lost. But I got the Cardinals winning here pretty easily. Next game we have is the Cowboys and Packers. I got the Cowboys winning just because they came off of the bye week, and the Packers just lost to the Lions, whose offense stinks. Next game we have is the Chargers and 49ers. And the 49ers also just came off of a bye week and are pretty fresh and healthy. Chargers just came off of the win. And if I'm going to have to go with anybody, I'm going to go with the 49ers because Christian McCaffrey is a very good asset to that team. And the last game of the week, we have the Commanders and Eagles. Eagles are 8-0, and I do not see them being 8-1. I see them being 9-0, but only because they have an easy schedule. Obviously, Jalen Hurts is a very good quarterback, but they just play easy teams, and obviously the Eagles are going to win this week. And that wraps it up for episode 2 of The Buck. Tune in next time to hear more predictions and more stat lines. I'll see y'all later.